Thank you. Chairwoman Waters.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. I'd like to also thank the ranking member, Mr. Cole, and members of the committee. Today, I'm here to discuss my amendment to ensure that federal housing funds are not used to perpetuate anti-blackness and racial injustice. Specifically, my amendment would ensure federal housing funds cannot be used to exclude Black Native Americans of the five tribes who are descendants of freedmen. I recognize that Native communities face some of the worst housing conditions in the United States. That's why I have proposed providing $2 billion for Native communities in my Housing is Infrastructure Act, and why I'm moving to reauthorize NAHASDA. However, we must ensure that every Native American household has equal access to federal resources, and right now, that's not the case. Not many are familiar with the history of those who came to be known as freedmen. The freedmen were Black individuals who were enslaved by five formerly slaveholding tribal nations. The freedmen were forced to walk the Trail of Tears alongside their slave masters, and at the end of the Civil War were guaranteed full tribal citizenship under treaty agreements between these formerly slaveholding tribes and the United States government in 1866. Specifically, the 1866 treaties required the five tribes to abolish slavery and to agree to treat formerly enslaved individuals and their lineal descendants as equal to Native tribal citizens. Despite the fact that these treaty obligations still exist and are binding on the five tribes, the descendants of freedmen continue to be denied tribal citizenship and other basic rights associated with citizenship, like equal access to federal housing assistance. While tribes like the Cherokee Nation have begun to make good on that promise after decades of litigation that ultimately reaffirmed the legal rights of the freedmen, others have not. To this day, there are descendants of freedmen who are denied the full benefits of equal citizenship in certain tribes based on their African ancestry, including access to federal housing funding provided in this bill. When Barney Frank was chairman of the House Financial Services Committee, he recognized the plight of the freedmen and was a staunch advocate for their rights. I worked with him closely on legislation to prevent tribes from disenfranchising their descendants. As ranking member and now chairwoman of the committee, I continue that fight for justice for the descendants of freedmen. I am sensitive to the fact that many confuse this issue with tribal sovereignty. However, tribal sovereignty should not be interpreted to give tribal nations the ability to ignore treaty requirements, nor should it be interpreted to prevent Congress from enforcing such requirements. Tribal sovereignty is a recognition of tribes as independent sovereign nations with the right to self-governance. It is not an infringement of tribal sovereignty to prevent federal housing funding from being used to perpetuate the ongoing discrimination and marginalization of the descendants of freedmen in direct violation of treaty requirements that the tribes agreed to. We must stand by the rights promised to freedmen all those centuries ago by passing this amendment, and I urge my colleagues to support it. And I thank you, and I'm happy to take any questions you may have.
Thank you, Chairwoman Waters. Ms.